All right, thanks for checking your forecast out inside WESH.com. I'm First Alert meteorologist Eric Burris. After a stormy Saturday afternoon, we quiet things down for your evening and overnight. Here's a look at the satellite and radar. Multiple reports of hail, winds over 60 miles an hour, good old-fashioned wet microbursts and downdrafts moved on through. It was a nasty go of it, but of course, through the evening, those winds will quiet down. Temperatures will fall off into the low and middle range of the 70s across central Florida. But as we look ahead to your Sunday, we'll keep it about the same forecast, a stray shower or thunderstorm around. But man, the heat is going to be the big story of the day. 98 degrees from the Villages down through Claremont. 97 is my forecast in Orlando, and Daytona Beach, 93 degrees in Titusville. That is a scorcher. Now, with that kind of heat, you're going to develop a few storms, but rain chances will still remain lower than average. Here's 7 o'clock in the morning. We're starting off nice and quiet. By about lunchtime, 1, 2 o'clock, we begin to develop a few things around Polk County, Marion, and Sumter counties. And you notice as the sea breezes kind of move on through, they don't do a whole heck of a lot. A couple of little thunderstorms here or there, and then some late evening storms. This is about 9 o'clock, a few guys moving on through the metro area. But again, with the high pressure, the way that it's settled, the best chance for the bigger thunderstorms is going to be once more around Sumter, Lake, and Marion counties. But a few of these guys, you know how Mother Nature works, will sneak right into the metro area, as it always tends to do. So here's a look at the forecast temperatures on the left and the records on the right. We'll get close to it, I think, in Orlando. Daytona Beach, you'll be a little bit further away. Melbourne, thankfully, you're the cool spot at 92 degrees, which is, by the way, the average high temperature this time of year. So high temperatures in the 90s, seas for the boaters running about, say, 2 to 3 feet. Not bad if you're wanting to take to the boat, but just keep an eye to the sky. I think the storms, though, should be inland from you. So here's the forecast then. It's another day with low rain coverage for your Sunday. Showers and thunderstorms, though, returning in a big way for the work week, and long-term models saying Saturday into Sunday could be very wet as a little mesoscale convective system tries to develop. All that means for you and I, got to watch next weekend.